Given that the inner cylinder rotates with an angular velocity omega, and the gap is given as, say, delta, which is 0.02 mm, and the diameter of the cylinder, inner cylinder, is given as 75 mm. H is given as 150 mm, and the omega is given as 100 revolution per minute. Converting it into radians per second, 1 revolution will be 2 pi radians into 360 into pi by 180 into 1 by 60, which will be 10.472 radians per second. Pi, I wrote it in degrees and I converted it into radians, so it is radians per second. Or you can say n is 100 revolution per minute. Then omega will be 2 pi n by 60, substituting 2 pi into n is 100 by 60, it will be 2 pi into 100 by 60 will be 10.472 radians per second. V equal to omega into R. R omega, R is 75 by 2 into 10 power minus 3 in meters into 10.472. That will be equal to 0.39 meter per second. The velocity distribution will be V, and here it is delta. So dou V by dou Y will be V by delta. And given we need to find tau, we have torque, that is 0.021 Newton meter. We know that the tau into pi D, that is the perimeter, into H will be the height, into D by 2, that is the perpendicular distance, will be equal to torque, from which tau will be equal to 0.021 by pi into diameter is 75 square into 10 power minus 6 by 2 into 150 into 10 power minus 3, then this will be equal to 0.021 into 2 by pi into 75 square into 150 into 10 power minus 9 will be equal to 15.844 Newton per meter square. So the viscosity will be tau by dou V by dou Y, which will be equal to 15.844 Newton per meter square by V is 0.39 meter per second, by delta is 0.02 into 10 power minus 3, it converts into meter, and this will be 1 by second, which will be 8.125 into 10 power minus 4 Newton second per meter square. 1 Newton second per meter square is 10 poise. So mu will be equal to 8.125 into 10 power minus 3 poise.